Back here at Google Next 2019, here in the booth, again, bringing you some great technologies. James, good to have you here.
Glad to be here.
Great. So, first time, pretty new with the company, correct?
Yes, only been here a little while.
And where are you from?
So, I'm from a large background of mostly enterprise technologies, working with some SharePoint, working with some Power BI, working with pretty much anything that will make lives easier, to take more time from doing those tedious tasks to helping people do things a little bit faster.
And where are you based?
I'm based in Seattle, up in the Pacific Northwest.
Beautiful new office we have up there. If you haven't checked it out, please check it out. So one of the things, you're pretty new with the company, and one of the things that I always like to talk to our customers about and ask you, how did you learn about our products?
Oh man, it was the easiest thing I have ever learned. Because I just went to the site, I looked for Academy, and I mean, I got directed to the Academy. I was just looking for learning, and it directed me to UiPath Academy. I went in there, and my first time, I was just watching some videos of people using it. And I was like, okay, pause the video, follow them along a little bit, play it, follow along, pause, keep doing that. And next thing I know, like, I was able to do everything I just saw them do in a matter of minutes. Now that I figured out they actually have courses, which would have made it a lot easier, that's step-by-step guides.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's... But even doing it the way I did it, I was able to find it, figure it all out, get dangerous, and build anything I wanted.
Awesome. So uses Academy. We use Academy for our internal people. Same learning and same Academy that you can use as a customer, right? Going from general RPA essentials all the way into master certification RPA developer, right?
Correct.
And you know, RPA smart people, you guys are on your path to get there. So now, being new to the company, what I always like to talk to our customers about is, give me a quick overview of our products, right? How do you explain and how did you learn? Give me a quick overview of what we do.
Yeah, so the first way I actually learned was just using the most basic thing possible in the studio. And that was just using the recorder, which we can find up here in the upper part of it, recorder.
So if I want to record something, if I don't know how to code, not even drag and dropping, I just want to record the process that I do on my desktop.
Correct.
I can start doing that.
So
it looks
sure
like
can.
Desktop, web, image, a lot of options.
Yes, a lot of different options in there. Okay. So, I mean, we have your basic one, which is just gonna be like, you're not really sure what to do, you can start there. Desktop would be kind of like your different desktop applications.
Okay.
But typically, you know, you're probably working a lot in the browser. Maybe you're just trying to go to a different site and log in and do some steps through there. You have that option.
So let's go to the web and see what we can do.
Yeah.
Do a quick little recording of something.
Yeah, so over here I have this, I'm gonna open up a browser. And I'm just going to open up Internet Explorer, which you need to click this, open browser. So this is actually just RPA challenge site.
Okay, that's fine. It's just anything. So you're opening the browser.
So right here, it's just asking you for the URL of what you're working with. And this one's just RPA challenge. So I'll come into this, do this. So then maybe the next thing I want to do is, this is actually, I wasn't planning to jump into, you know, this challenge here, right here. But, you know, while it's already up, so we have different things like your phone number, your address, last name, you know, just typical input forms. And so maybe I always want to type in my first name in here. Type. So I'll find the first name field right here. And just comes up here, typing in James. Click enter, and there we go. Typed it in for me.
Okay, so that's recorded. So let's go back out and see what that looks like. So now that I've recorded it.
So now I'm going to click save and exit. And boom, it just builds out the entire thing for me in Studio.
Okay, so this is what, I mean, and this is Studio. This is actually the automation that we're doing. So it's actually built this out on the fly.
Yes.
Web, Citrix, PDFs, whatever you're doing, desktop applications, all right here, and now you're ready to go.
Yes, all built out, ready to go.
Very simple and easy to use, of course. That's one of our huge tenets in our applications and products. Ease of use and the ability to start working very quickly in the application.
Very quickly.
Okay, show me a little bit what the activities box looks like.
Yeah, so over here we have activities. And I've kind of got some of my favorites up here, the quick ones that you would work to quick, fast. Some of them, a lot of these will be using terminology that can be very familiar to any developers, but if you're not a developer, they're also, you could quickly get dangerous with them and understand what they are. So over here, we have some UI automation. Like maybe you want to work with, UI is a term which I found out from my wife that a lot of people weren't familiar with, stands for user interface.
Yeah.
And this is anything that you are actually touching on the computer screen.
Exactly.
So in this, we have your elements, like maybe you want to use your mouse in here. Maybe you want to use your keyboard and work through different things. Controls are going to be anything that's, you know, your typical things like check boxes, drop down boxes.
So lots of options.
Yeah, lots of options.
About 300 plus activities actually ship in studio. Plus you can have your own, you can build in more.
We're getting
more connectors, more computer vision stuff coming out. We did a computer vision also just earlier, so make sure you check out that demo. Great technology. Okay, let's jump. So now that I have my automation, right, what do I do next?
So the next thing you do is, you know, I just typed in here, I just put my first name, James, and maybe you want to put something else in here. So now that you have like the basics in here, you could probably variableize this, maybe put it in different ways to make it in there. But let's suppose we got all this done, we got this where we want to. Next thing we want to do, obviously we want to run it.
Okay.
So over here, I'm just going to, I have a robot. And this little UI icon right here, you'll see these are my robots.
Okay. Now, these are robots or automations?
Both.
Okay.
So these are automations that my robot can run.
Okay, great. Because again, a robot, 24/7 worker, right, works linearly. So every process I give, it'll go through the process linear 24/7. I can just continue running things through. So, and you can access it directly from the desktop. So that's cool.
Yeah. Super easy. The other option is, let's suppose that you built this all out and now you want to actually have it run on other people's computers. You want to push it all out there. And that's where we have our orchestrator, which is our browser version. So you come over here and we have orchestrator. Super easy to get to. Okay. Once you get your studio connected into it, you just click publish, sends your process up here, and then you have everything available. So once you can get it all connected, you know, maybe have it connected in just a matter of minutes.
Okay.
The tutorials are super easy. Just follow along and you'll be right there. Next thing you know, you won't be using the tutorials.
Let's walk down. So we got robots on the top.
Yes,
that's
we have
robots
all the robots top.
That you would have, right?
Yes.
Unattended or attended. Doesn't matter
correct.
For us. Okay. And then go down to machines. Those are the things that we're running. We got 10 machines, processes. And those are all the processes that I've assigned to those
robots.
And these
are the workflows like we just built out in the studio.
Gotcha.
So when I push those up there, this is where you would start finding them.
Okay, fantastic. And libraries?
Yes, libraries. So libraries would just be like, maybe you start putting in those custom activities or start putting out different general tool sets that you can use to bring in.
So Studio, where you can create all your automations, right? We've got
yes.
Orchestrator, which allows us to control and kind of organize all of our robots and processes automatically. And then, of course, the robot, unattended or attended, right from the desktop, or if you wanted to push that on an unattended robot somewhere on a server or a VM, correct?
Brent, how about we explain to people maybe what an intended robot is versus unattended?
That's great.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
So we have two different things. General concept is unattended is a robot that you would have separate that would not need a human interaction with.
Okay, just throwing processes at it.
Yes. So unattended could be off on another computer, doing its own thing, running off different things. Maybe you're pushing different processes to it.
Server. It could sit on a server.
Yeah,
okay.
Server.
Good point.
An attended robot is what I have right here, one that's on my machine, and it's one that may need some human interaction. Like maybe it's going and it's doing those things that it prompts up like, hey, James, I need help with this. What number should have actually been in here? I'm not really sure of the correct thing in here. That would be an attended robot.
Again, human in the loop. So that's fantastic. Great explanation. Make sure the customers understand that too, because we do have robots, unattended and attended. Orchestrated allows us to organize that, and Studio, which allows us to create those automations. So a quick overview. Thanks, James, for giving us kind of a quick overview of the platform products that we have. We'll be coming to you with more demonstrations and technology from Google Next. So follow us on social, and we'll talk to you soon. Thanks, James. Appreciate it.
Thank you.